it's a partial process, and concrescence is what waits at the end. The eschaton is the concrescence. And the reason why is because asking that question is like asking a man looking east at 2 a.m. to describe the coming sunrise. He can't, because it is literally over the event horizon of the future. And when we look into the future, we see that the east is streaked with rosy dawn, but we cannot conceive of the day that is about to come. All we can see is the dim glow of some kind of eschatological promise. Ask me this question in 2010, and I'll have a different answer. Well, the main reason physicists are not friendly to a progressive concrescent model like this is because you would have to give credit to biology for being a stage higher than chemistry, and you would have to give credit to human history as a stage higher than biology. And physicists study physics. If you study physics, there is no biology. You don't have to deal with issues of biology when you study physics. I mean, there is something called biophysics, but it's not well received in physics or biology. So physicists tend to discount biology, even though life on this planet is 4.83 billion years old. Physicists just discount it. They call it an epiphenomenon. Well, then when you talk to sociologists, they give no credit to physics. Science has compartmentalized nature in order to analyze it, and there is no theory of nature as such. And that's really what I'm offering. I'm offering a theory which covers physics, chemistry, geology, biology, sociology, linguistics, the whole thing. In other words, not saying man is some special category, not saying that we need artificial divisions, but that over the entire domain of known phenomena.